let's just talk about Europe for, you know, as a prince.
We have, and I know where you're going with this. Like,
welcome to Last Words Here in the Pit. I'm your host, Jordan Olds from 2 Minutes to Late Night.
And I'm Katy Irizarry of Season of Mist and Loudwire.
And I am Doc Coyle from the band Bad Wolves and also host of the X-Men podcast.
All right, everybody. So this week we are joined by Zach Ezrin of Imperial Triumphant, avant-garde black metal band.
Zombi 2020. Zombi is the band, 2020 is the album. John Carpenter is the sound. I'm usually super into like a synth wave kind of thing, but now there's so much of it that like so many people are doing this. Like you have like Carpenter Brutes and like Perturbator. I don't know. I feel like I gotta like pick and choose a little bit. This is good, but I think that there are just people who are a little ahead of the game on this genre. One of them is John Carpenter. I think his recent stuff is really sick. He pretty much invented the and then he like came back and be like, give me my money. I'm here. I'm curious to see where this band goes in the future when they maybe have, I don't know, when they grow a little bit. I don't know. What do you think, Katy?
You know, it's funny because I also felt this was like very soundtracky, very video gamey. But I actually kind of liked it because I felt, unlike some of the bands that you mentioned, like Perpetrator, or however you say it, again, we already know I can't talk like a regular person. I don't know how to say words. It's a little more dynamic. I think it has a couple different moods. You know, some songs are a little bit brighter that kind of remind me more of like that Night Flight Orchestra kind of vibe. But then some songs are a little more ominous and darker. So I just thought that was pretty interesting that it definitely had a little bit more of a spectrum to it than some of the other synthwave.
Totally.
So made me appreciate it. Is it something I'll listen to again? Maybe not. But you know what? I think it would totally be something solid that I could see going, like we said, like into like a video game or something. I think it could be a component to something bigger.
Yeah, I'm thinking like I'm agreeing with both of you. I think this record, first of all, what great luck that they called the record 2020 and it came out 2020. Like genius. I think that it's actually like it's a really creative record, and there's a lot of like everything you kind of mentioned. This, you know, John Carpenter style, this old school film score style, and I would love to see them kind of run with that and sort of take it into a more of a film score direction, or make some, you know, try to make some music videos that have like a complementary visual to it, because I feel like there's so much more to do with the music than just listen to it, that it could be there's a lot of possibilities, you know what I mean?
It's funny because this genre, synthwave, I don't know if you guys can see around my room, but I've seen John Carpenter the last 2 years. Like, it's like basically any band that synthwave band, it's like put it in my veins. Like I never get tired of it. I could listen to it all day. You know, I listen to this band Meteor. You know, mm-hmm. I listen to what's his name? Myron. I think that's how you pronounce it. It seems like this album though, they front loaded it to be more synthwavey in the first few songs. But as the album actually goes on, it gets actually much more 70s prog. And some of it even reminded me of like Opeth and kind of some of that stuff. So I actually do think they're trying not to be a stereotypical synthwave sound. And I think they are kind of, they're using that to lure you in. And then it is going down all these pathways. But I just think they're a brilliant band.
Yeah, I agree. The end of the album, it sounds like the middle of like Yes songs for sure. But these guys, you know what? I'm going to give it like another go, because maybe I'm just listening to it expecting it to be something that it isn't.
Is this a touring band? I don't really know much about them.
Are they?
We have no idea. Thank you for asking.
It could be kind of cool to see them live. I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Dark Sarah. The album is called Grim. You know what? Go off with your anime video game soundtrack. Go off, weebs. Have fun. It's fun. I don't know. It's anime. Go. What do you think?
This sort of style, it sounds pretty grim. it's really not like for me, but I think that, you know what, let's just say something nice. It's got decent production.
There you go. The lighting was nice.
They had a cool video.
I love this shit. You know, I kind of wish, let's just talk about Europe for, you know, as a place.
We have, and I know where you're going with this.
Like, I think when we lend our kind of American ears to some stuff like this, like it's just so foreign, and it's just a certain thing that they do and culturally that they embrace that really works. And there's a, you know, and me, there's a certain band, you know, like an Amon Amarth or, you know, Halloween, like this stuff that to a certain lens, it feels very cheesy and kind of over the top, but that's like the point. And
yeah.
I just, the thing is, like, they had riffs, they had some big riffs in there, and that got me going. And I just love the ambition, and it was fun.
Yeah, it is a lot of fun. I guess, like, Dark Sarah is the name of the anime, and, like, the anime is about, like, a lady who has a giant jacket, but the jacket is made out of belts, and she has a sword, but the sword is a gun. You know, that's what this is.
I will say, for people who do like this kind of music, because there is a very big market for it, this music does so well in Europe, and it actually does well here. It's very, like, power metal, like, cinematic, symphonic. I would say for people who do like this music, very similar to like Delane, if you're familiar with them, or also Doc had mentioned Nightwish. I think that's a good, basically it sounds, I meant to look up the label, but this definitely sounds like something Napalm Records put out. I don't know if they did, but it sounds like they could have.
They did.
See, they did. I just know Napalm Records bands now when I hear them.
And lastly, we have Detriment from Entry. I did not know about this band. I love, this is so my shit, this late 90s hardcore comeback. The guitarist of Touche Amour, I don't know how to say that band, Amore, is on this record, if that means something to you. I had a great, this is my favorite record of the week, but that's because I love gross hardcore. What do you think, Zach?
I think it's brutal, man. This one is definitely, I agree, this might be my favorite one of the week. But I really, and this is coming from a guitar player, I love the bass on this record. I think it's,
yeah, fat,
it's savage. And I got to give it up. It sounds brutal, and the vocals are just super, super angry, which I think is it's supposed to be.
Yeah, absolutely. This was a We're All Having Throat Coat tea after this record.
Yeah.
All right, well, that does it for Last Words here in the pit. I'm Jordan Olds. Please follow 2 Minutes to Late Night at 2M2LN, at 2 Minutes to Late Night on Instagram. Katie, plugs!
At Merciful Kate, Twitter and Instagram.
Doc, where can the people find you?
You can check me out on Instagram and Twitter at Doc Coyle. Also check out my website, www.doccoyle.net, and my podcast, The X-Man. Boom.
Boom. Amazing job. Zach, where can the people find you and your band? Tell them about the album. Do all the stuff.
Check out our new album coming out on Century Media, July 31st, Alphaville. You can listen to it and stream it on Spotify, Apple Music, or pick it up on vinyl. Gorgeous vinyl, might I add. Double gatefold. And add us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, all Imperial Triumphant, or check out our website, imperial-triumphant.com.
Hell yeah. And if there's anything we forgot to talk about, let us know in the comments. We will read them. We really will do it. Even if you're mean, we'll do it. Follow us on social media at We Are The Pit. We're here every Thursday talking about the goings on of the metal world and reviewing the albums. Goodbye.